What's up, guys? RyHo here, and of course, the other day, on the last Oda Horror I did, I talked about The Thing from Another World, and you knew if I was going to talk about that one, I had to talk about the remake, John Carpenter's The Thing from 1982. And as you could tell by the title sequence, the reason this whole thing kind of came about was recently Cole and I, a couple weeks ago, got to see The Thing in theater. It was part of a little series of films that one of the local theaters was doing midnight showings of. First one was like 12 Monkeys, which I'm not all that interested in myself. I'm not a big fan of the movie. The Fly, which I would have gone to see but couldn't. And then the last one was The Thing, and we definitely had to catch that, so we went and saw. Actually, I have my ticket in the case here for the film. Right here. And as you can see, I have a nice, crisp, new Blu-ray edition of The Thing. That's right, I have gone high def. I've had Blu-rays before, you guys have seen that. I've had a Blu-ray player for a couple of years now in my PlayStation 3, but I haven't had the TV to watch it, but recently I got myself a nice 1080p television and been enjoying some Blu-rays. This is actually the first horror Blu-ray that I picked up. But enough of that, I guess. We'll get into The Thing here. There are a few remakes out there that whenever people complain about remakes, they do the remake bashing. There's always a couple that come up as remakes that were really, really great and, you know, prove the stereotype wrong. And this is the number one, I think, most certainly, that comes up every time. You know, well, we'll remember John Carpenter's The Thing. Again, based on the short story, Who Goes There by John W. Campbell. However, this film is it's based on that short story. It's actually much more directly based to the short story than The Thing from Another World is, but at the same time, it's also a remake of The Thing from Another World, which is kind of a weird thing. In the short story, although you don't see it, it sort of starts with all of the researchers and all the different guys that are up in this, you know, or down in this Antarctic sort of research station. Talking about how they, you know, they noticed something was out in the ice because there was a problem with the magnetic poles. They went out, they found the ship, they used thermite trying to dig it out, they destroyed the ship by accident, and they ended up finding an occupant frozen in the ice. And it sort of starts with them, and they're sort of huddled around the frozen thing that they're, and they're talking about with what happened. So that part is sort of in the original film, and this version, basically, the idea is that there was a Norwegian team that dug up the original ship and creature, and that the group that's in this film, another research team, an American research team, comes in contact with the Norwegians because they're trying to kill this dog. They don't know what's going on at the start of the film. And they end up going up to their research station to see what's going on. They find it destroyed. And eventually they do find, you know, that they dug up something in the ice. And so, in a sense, it's much more close to the short story, that the characters in this are from the short story, MacReady, all those guys. But at the same time, you know, there's sort of this element of the original film in there. Actually, I always found the scenes with the Norwegians, where they find the Norwegian tapes, it's almost like they're looking at that original team. Like, there's a scene where the Norwegians are all standing next to each other in a line, and I always think that that's sort of the original research team, you know, in the original film. Just like how they, when they found the ship, they made that circle, they all stood up with their arms. And sort of that thing. So, but it's a remake of the original film slash the a more direct translation of the short story. But beyond that, this is like, you know, it's funny. The first time I saw this film, my cousin, he was like, you know, you got to see The Thing. You got to see The Thing. I hadn't seen it, so he lent me his DVD. I watched it and I really enjoyed it. I didn't really go back to watch it. You know, I always thought, you know, this is a really great John Carpenter film, but never really thought about it that much. Having an opportunity to see it in the theater actually, like, changed my outlook on the film completely. And I think Cole said the same thing, too. You know, seeing in theater made me realize how much I actually really, really love this film. It's actually one of those sort of, like, top five shifters in your horror movies and stuff like that. I don't know for sure, but it's just, I had a whole new outlook on this film. And it's funny because the screening we saw was a really, really old. Everything was really red tinted because it was such an old film reel, but watching it again on the big screen, just I was like, man, this is so awesome. I can't believe that, you know, I haven't been watching this over and over again, and which is why I went out and picked up the Blu-ray. I'd heard that it had a pretty good transfer, so I had to go out and get it. And the transfer on this is out of this world, really. And I hate to use the pun, but it's it made the film look that much better. You know, I've seen the DVD version. I've never watched the VHS version, so I don't know what that was like. And I've seen this sort of old film reel version, and this is just unbelievable, the transfer on this. To the point where, actually, it's funny. I watched it with commentary the other night, and it has a really great commentary, which I think is from the DVD, with Kurt Russell and John Carpenter. And they point out some things, and with the really enhanced sort of visuals in the film, you start to notice some stuff about the special effects. But still, I'm not going to rag on special effects, because I think that this film has some of the best creature effects that have ever been put to film. Some of the stuff that happens is just twisted, it's fucked up, it is out of this world again. I hate to use that pun again, but and you have to see it to believe it, I think, is the best way to put it, because it just doesn't make sense. It's just how they even thought of this fucking stuff. I can't even begin. It is unbelievable creature effects. It has this amazing vibe, you know, an isolated feel, which is these 12 men that are trying to deal with the situation. Again, there's that play, that sort of character play, like in the original film. It's like the monster's out there. It's much more prevalent in this film, and it attacks them, and it does all these horrible things. But it's almost, at the same time, it's man against man. It's really about who is the thing, you know, who goes there is, you know, an apt title for the short story, because they don't know, you know, who actually is the thing. And it's just an unbelievable piece. The music by Ennio Morricone, it just adds to it. It's this great synth and orchestral track. Great acting by all the people involved, of course, Kurt Russell, and great direction by John Carpenter. Watching him talk about the scenes in the commentary about the things that he had to do in that, you know, it really gives you a greater respect for the film and him as a filmmaker. And this was actually his first studio film, I believe, so it was just an unbelievable effort by everybody that was in it. Rob Bottin, special effects. I know Stan Winston had some, I think he did the dog special effect, the dog monster sort of thing in the film. And I can't say it. I can gush about this movie all day. I can't say enough about it. So I just wanted to talk about it because I had seen it basically in the theater, and I really wanted to get my thoughts out there. I hope you guys enjoyed the review or whatever. And you definitely have to go out and check out The Thing. And if you have a Blu-ray player, this is actually, I think this is a pretty budget title for Blu-ray players. I mean, there's not a whole lot of special features on it. It has the commentary with Kurt Russell and John Carpenter. It also has this U Control sort of exclusive thing where while you're watching the movie, you can click on certain spots and different people come up and talk about some of the scenes in the film, which I haven't gone through yet, but it has that. It's sort of a picture-in-picture thing. And other than that, I don't think it has a whole lot else, but the transfer on it is just unbelievable. I was actually blown away. This is the first really old movie I've watched in Blu-ray, so I was really, really shocked by it. So definitely, guys, you know, you got to go check out The Thing. Regardless, get it on VHS, get it on DVD, I don't care. But yeah, that's my thoughts on The Thing, and I'll let you guys go, and I hope you enjoy, as usual. So I will talk to you soon, and peace.
Roboting is a coked up brain.